Students, welcome to you all. Today through the video I will discuss about the graph of a cubic polynomial and relationship between zeros and coefficients of a polynomial. The graph of a cubic polynomial is not of any standard shape. For a cubic polynomial, ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, the graph of the corresponding equation y equal to ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d is any curve which crosses the x axis at least once and at most thrice as shown in the given graphs. Dear students, in graph 1, we draw the graph of y is equal to x cube. Here note that 0 is the only 0 of the polynomial x cube. Also from figure 1, we can see that 0 is the x coordinate of the only point where the graph of y equal to x cube intersects the x axis. In figure 2, we draw the graph of y equal to x cube minus x. Here note that 0 and 1 are the only zeros of the polynomial x cube minus x square. Also from figure 2, these values are the x coordinates of the only points where the graph of y equal to x cube minus x square intersects the x axis. Similarly, in figure 3, we draw the graph of y is equal to we draw the graph of y equal to x cube minus 4x. Here note that minus 2, 0 and 2 are the only zeros of the polynomial x cube minus 4x. Also from figure 3, these values are the x coordinates of the only points where the graph of y equal to x cube minus 4x intersects the x axis. So we can say that a cubic polynomial can have at the least one zero and at most three zeros. Now we summarize the above discussion in the form of a table given below. In first column we write a polynomial, in the second column we write shape of the graph, in third column we write number of points at which the graph of the polynomial intersects or touches x axis, and in column fourth we write number of zeros. In column 1, the polynomial is linear, the shape of the graph is straight line, number of points at which the graph of polynomial intersects or touches x axis is 1, and the number of zeros is also 1. For quadratic polynomial, shape is parabola, number of points that is 0, 1 and 2, and number of zeros that is no 0, 1 0, 2 0 is maximum. For cubic polynomial, shape no standard shape, number of points 1, 2 and 3, number of zeros 1 0, least 2 zeros and 3 zeros maximum. Thus, we conclude that the graph of nth degree polynomial crosses the x-axis at the most at n points. Therefore, a polynomial px of degree n has at most n zeros. Now, let us find the solution of exercise 2.1 from NCERT. Question number 1. The graph of y is equal to px are given in figure below for some polynomials px. Find the number of zeros of px in each case. Dear students, here I will discuss about only 3 parts and remaining 3 parts are homework for you. From first graph, we see that the graph of px does not intersect x-axis, so px has no zero. From the third graph, we see that the graph of px intersects x-axis at 3 points, so px has 3 zeros. And from the fourth graph, the graph we see that the graph of px intersects x-axis at 2 points, so px has 2 zeros. Now we will discuss about relationship between zeros and coefficients of a polynomial. Let alpha and beta be the zeros of a quadratic polynomial px equal to ax square plus bx plus c, where a not equal to 0 and a, b, c are real numbers. Then x minus alpha and x minus beta are the factors of px by factor theorem. So we can write px is equal to k into in bracket x minus alpha into in bracket x minus beta, where k is a non-zero constant. Implies that ax square plus bx plus c equal to k into, if we multiply x minus alpha into x minus beta, we get x square minus in bracket alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. So we can write ax square plus bx plus c equal to kx square minus k into in bracket alpha plus beta into x plus k alpha beta. Now, comparing the coefficients of x square, x and constant terms on both sides, we get a is equal to k, b equal to minus k into alpha plus beta, and c is equal to k alpha beta. This is as 1. Now, we take b is equal to minus k into alpha plus beta from 1, and this is implied that minus a alpha plus beta equal to b. Why? Since k is a is equal to k, and this is implied that alpha plus beta can be written minus b by a, and this is implied that sum of zeros equal to minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. Similarly, from 1, k alpha beta is equal to c. So we can write k alpha beta is equal to c, since k is equal to a. So alpha beta is equal to c by a, which is implied that product of zeros equal to constant term by coefficient of x square. Thus, the sum of zeros, that is alpha plus beta, is equal to minus b by a, and product of zeros, that is alpha beta, equal to c by a. Here, the assignment is given, that is exercise 2.1 from NCERT. Thank you.